Good morning. It's lovely to see you. As we wait for all this to arrive, can we just take a moment just to be settled in the presence of God? We're going to stand. If you can stand, please stand with us. We're going to open up in prayer. We're all going to pray together. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let's just settle ourselves. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And worship to you. You can join me in prayer as well. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord God. We honor you. We give glory to your name. You are the resurrection and the life, oh God. You are, Lord God, the King of Kings. You still reign on your throne. And we thank you, Lord, that we're able to come and see the day, Lord Jesus, that you have made. Lord Jesus, because you reign, Lord God, we have hope. Because you reign, Lord Jesus, we have life. Oh God, because you reign, Lord Jesus, we have mercy. We have grace. Oh God, with us. We are, Lord Jesus, the resurrection, Lord God, the proof that of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Father God, we thank you, Lord, that you are amongst us. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are here, you're tabernacling with your people. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, that you've rested upon us this morning, that you've protected us, oh God, and have brought us here safely, Lord God. I pray for everyone, Lord God, that comes into your presence, that comes into this sanctuary, that they'll be filled. That they will be renewed, oh Lord Jesus. We seek you this morning and nobody else, no other name, no other name but the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we lift you up, oh Lord. We lift you up, Lord Jesus. We worship you, oh Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is our testimony. This is our song. Oh God, you have been good to us. Hallelujah. Your mercy never fails us, oh Lord Jesus. You are forever faithful, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for your grace. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And we settle ourselves before you, Lord Jesus. We humble ourselves before you, Lord. Hallelujah. We surrender ourselves to you, oh Lord. Have your way in this place, oh God. Have your way in this place. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, abide with us, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let nothing that we do, Lord Jesus, be in vain this morning, because it is all to your glory and all to your honor, Lord Jesus, and all, Lord Jesus, to the magnification of your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Open up your mouths. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We cannot be silent this morning, church. We come here this morning to celebrate a risen King, a God that is alive, a God that's given us life. Hallelujah. We cannot be silent. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, we honor you. We celebrate you this morning, Jesus. Hallelujah. We celebrate you this morning, oh Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Just lift up your praise. Lift up your praise. Hallelujah. Open your mouth and lift up your praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. What other God is there that has died and risen from the dead? What other God is there that gives us, that's able to give us eternal life? What other God saves and sustains? It's only Jehovah God, amen? It's only Jesus. I only know of one man that came to this earth, that died and actually rose from the dead again, and with that gave everyone else life. Can you imagine? Church, no other God, no prophet, no Muhammad, no Buddha, amen. No Krishna, amen. No Vishnu, or Vashti, what is it called? There are so many of them. But no other God, there is no other God that has risen from the dead. Our King is alive. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Our King is alive. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I hope someone's ready to celebrate. I hope someone is really ready to celebrate this morning.
Amen.
We're going to sing Celebrate, Jesus, Celebrate. He has risen. He has risen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me quickly share with you such a funny thing. Isaiah 25, and I'll just share with you, where's my verse? Verse 7 and 8 and 9. So that's Isaiah 25, verse 7, 8, and 9. On this mountain he will destroy the shroud that enfolds all people, the sheet that covers all nations. He will swallow up death forever. The sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces. He will remove his people's disgrace from all the earth. The Lord has spoken. Verse 9, in that day they will say, surely this is our God. We trusted in him and he saved us. This is the Lord, we trusted in him. Let us rejoice and be glad in his salvation. Amen? And you're probably wondering, why on earth did she pick such a verse? But this verse is also prophetic. It's prophetic of the coming death and resurrection of our Lord. Not just for the people of that day to be saved, but for us today, generations after, to inherit salvation. Amen. And today we stand in the resurrection and the power of Jesus Christ. So that's what we're gonna do. Hallelujah. We're gonna celebrate this morning. Death has no power over us because Jesus has conquered the grave. He has the keys to death and the grave. Amen. So death doesn't hold you. And for those who are getting baptized, it's encouragement. You have new life. Your past cannot hold you. Once you go down in that water, the old man has died and the new man has resurrected. Amen? Hallelujah. Let us celebrate. Let us celebrate. Celebrate Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Can we just put our hands together? Celebrate it.
Celebrate,
celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. The musicians, or your neighbor, or your friend, whoever you're here with, you're here for God. I hope you're here for God. Hallelujah. We're going to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And this is a well-known song. So I hope you can join in with me. It says, "Lo, in the grave he lay, Jesus my Savior, waiting the coming day." Hallelujah. Jesus, my Lord. Hallelujah. I think it was maybe last year or the year before, I remember preaching where the speaker said there would be no Resurrection Sunday if there wasn't a Good Friday. Amen? So we have to die to live. It's a part of the process. The good thing is that we don't stay in the grave. And that is what we're here to celebrate this morning. Is anyone ready to join with me? Is anyone ready to join with me? You sound silent. Hallelujah. 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 Grab something. If it's a towel, if it's a handkerchief, if it's a tambourine, I don't know what other musical instruments you can play with, but if you need something to help you to celebrate, to worship God, then take it. It's a part of our worship. Amen? Low in the grave. Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Church.
Hallelujah.
I really, really don't think you understand the significance of today. I really don't think you understand it. And it's a subjective point of view. I hope you understand the meaning of today. If God didn't raise from the dead, if he didn't go to the grave, pay for your sins and actually raise from the dead, you would still be bound today. When we die, we just stay dead. We'd be in hell. Hallelujah. But with Christ, we have salvation, a hope of salvation that even though we pass from this earth, there is life after this earth. Do you understand? Hallelujah. There is life after this. The moment that you're living in right now is only by the mercy and the grace of God. Because the life after this, you can either go two places, one of two places. You can either go to heaven or you can go to hell. And I know we don't talk about it much anymore, but it is a real thing. Hell wasn't made for his people. Hell wasn't made for creation. But because of the fall, hell exists. And people still go there. But because of Christ, death cannot hold us down. Sin cannot hold us down. Our past cannot hold us back. We have hope that after this earth, we will get to heaven. We will see Jesus. Amen. We will see our loved ones. Amen. Hallelujah. This is the significance of the resurrection of life. This is the significance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's our living hope. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus. Just give God praise. Can we just take a moment, give God praise without any songs? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I thank you, Lord, for rescuing me, Lord Jesus. If it wasn't for you, hallelujah. If it wasn't for you, Lord God, I would have no hope of salvation. I thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That after this, I will be able to see you, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
There is a life after this. I will not die, but I will live. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord,
thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise
thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I worship you, God. I worship you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. How great the chasm. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Living God, you are our living hope. Living God, you are our living hope.
Hallelujah.
You are our living hope.
Then through the darkness,
then through the darkness.
your work is finished.
The end is written.
The end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope.
Who could imagine?
Who could imagine?
So great a mercy.
So great a mercy.
What heart could fathom?
What heart could fathom? Such boundless grace.
The God
of ages, step down from glory.
To wear my sin and bear my shame.
To wear my sin and bear my shame.
Buck the cross, buck the cross.
The cross has spoken.
The end.
I am forgiven.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings calls me.
Amen. Hallelujah. It is finished.
Beautiful Savior.
I'm yours.
I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my Lord.
Hallelujah.
declare the grave has no claim on me.
I want us to sing it with conviction.
Then came the morning that sealed the promise.
Your very body began to breathe.
Father. Hallelujah. He is Jesus Christ, the one who is truly righteous. He himself is the sacrifice that atones for our sins. And not only our sins, but the sins of all the world. Hallelujah. What a hope. What a privilege. Hallelujah. Nothing that we could do of ourselves. Hallelujah. Nothing that we deserve. But by grace. Amen. By grace. Hallelujah. What a privilege. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And that's why we say hallelujah so freely. Hallelujah. The highest praise deserves to go. He deserves our highest praise. Hallelujah. When we look back just at the last week, if we contemplate just the last week and consider the things that we've done, the things that we haven't done, but grace, but grace, but grace. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. You may be seated. Thank you, Jesus. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. Amen. Amen. Thank you, worship team. Hallelujah. Praise God. Can we put our hands together for the worship team? They ministered so powerfully. And thank you, musicians. Praise God. Hallelujah. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. We're here to celebrate not a Savior that is in the grave, but one that is resurrected and is our advocate. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. And I just want to welcome everyone who is here this morning. I want to particularly say welcome to those that have been away and have returned. Sister Abby, welcome back from your break. Sister Beverly Bennett, she's been away a long time, but it's so lovely to have you with us from the sunny island of St. Martin's. God bless you. I also want to welcome anyone who is here as family or friends of the baptism candidates. If you could just stand, just give us a wave. You don't need to say your name. Anyone that's here, friends or family of the baptism candidates. Hallelujah. Praise God. Good to have you with us. And is there anyone visiting for the first time? If you could just raise your hand so we can bless you. So lovely to have you, family. Thank you. You are so welcome. And feel free to just worship with us this morning. Praise God. And I'm just going to give you 2 minutes. 2 minutes just to say hi, just to greet someone, give them a Resurrection Sunday smile as the musicians play. Just 2 minutes. You have 2 minutes. You're on a timer. So use the time wisely. Bless God.
Tell
seconds to get back to your seat.
Everybody smile, everybody smile, everybody smile.
Just one more time.
Smile, everybody smile.
Bless God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. As you go back to your seat, I hope you feel welcome. I hope you received a smile or a hug or a handshake. Hallelujah. I'm going to invite the AV team just to play our announcements, and I would ask you to pay close attention to the announcements.
Thank you for joining us at NTCG Aldershot Community Church. Please pay careful attention to the following announcements, but don't worry if you miss anything, as the information will be replayed on a loop before and after service.
Please join us for a time of fellowship, refreshments and connections immediately after this morning service in the back hall. Everyone is welcome.
Following our Good Friday and Easter Sunday services, the youth department will be fundraising by selling fried fish and bun and cheese, as well as a clothes sale with both new and nearly new items. Please support as much as you can.
On Wednesday, the 3rd of April, from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m, the youth department will be hosting a Zoom forum on the topic of trauma. Please see Deacon Janice Green or the youth team for further details.
Join us for our next late night district prayer meeting on Friday the 1st of April at 10 p.m. Please use the details on screen to join.
On Sunday the 21st of April, the youth department will be hosting a youth day service on the theme, Breaking Ground by Restoring Hunger and Thirst. The guest speaker for the day will be Romaine Butler, our district youth director. Please see the youth team for further details. On Saturday the 27th of April, the Aldershot District Women's Discipleship Ministry invite you to our Grow Women Together conference. Join us at 2 p.m. for our women-only workshop with our guest facilitator Davinia Robinson. At 5:30 p.m, all are welcome to join us as we praise our risen Savior at our Grow Together in Praise and Worship service. Please see Maureen Cummins for further details.
In order to ensure there is no disruption for those who are watching on our stream, please refrain from walking across the front of the altar area during service.
For those who would like to participate in online giving, please send your tithes and offering to the details on screen and ensure your name is included in the reference. Please be aware that you can now give via QR code.
God bless you and enjoy the rest of the service.
Good morning, everyone. Hello? Good morning, everyone. It's so good to be in the house of the Lord on this special day. And you know, the song or the hymn, Up from the Grave He Arose. With a mighty triumph, oh, his foes. He arose a victor, though I'm not going to sing it, from the dark domain, and he lives forever with the saints to reign. He arose, hallelujah, Christ arose. And we sing this song, I know, traditionally every year, and every year it has more meaning and greater meaning, and I'm so glad that he arose. I don't know about you, but I would not be here if he hadn't arose, or risen, rather. I just wanted to, first of all, take this opportunity to give you Easter greetings. I'm glad you've greeted one another. It's so good to see you in the house of the Lord. Today I want to again greet Sister Beverly Bennett, her daughter Kim, and their son traveling down from the Midlands, and Bev is over here for a few weeks, so it's good to see her and the family in the house of the Lord today, and also Sister Nicole as well. God bless you, good to see you. Was Josh's mum-in-law. So good to see you in the house of the Lord this morning. Just wanted to mention a couple of things, and then we'll have a scripture reading. This coming Friday at 11 a.m. here, that's Friday the 5th of April, will be the funeral service of Raymond Gardner. Now, some of you may not know Raymond, but he was a son of, is the son of Sister Gardner and brother of Myrtle Gardner. And he'll be having his funeral service this coming Friday at 11 a.m. If you're able to attend, I know the kids are on holiday, which may make it easier, but if you're able to attend and support the family, they would greatly appreciate that. Also, on the 25th of April at 10:30, be the funeral service of Beverly Garrett. Beverly's was a former member of this district, but served on this district for many, many years in various capacities, and she was a member of the Farnborough Church. Her funeral service will be on Thursday, I believe it's a Thursday, but it's the 25th of April, and that will be at 10:30, so please make a note in your diaries. We're going to pray at this moment. I'm going to ask if we can have we're going to read from the Word of God at this moment, and then I'll be calling Sister Janice, one of our deacons here, to come and pray. But we're going to be reading from Matthew 28. If I can have the NIV version on the screen. You can remain seated for this, because it's we're going to be reading the whole chapter. Matthew chapter 28. After the Sabbath, at dawn, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you're looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He is risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he is risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you." So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them. "Greetings," he said. They came to him and clasped his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." While the women were on their way, some of the guards went into the city and reported to the chief priests everything that had happened. When the chief priests had met with the elders and devised a plan, they gave the soldiers a large sum of money, telling them, "You are to say his disciples came during the night and stole him away while we were asleep. If this report gets to the governor, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble." So the soldiers took the money and did as they were instructed. And this story has been widely circulated among the Jews to this very day. Verse 16. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I've commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age." Hallelujah. Can we stand, please? I'm going to come and invite our Deacon Janice Green just to come and pray a prayer of strengthening blessing over this church, over your lives. Can we just bow our heads as she comes before the Lord?
Hello. Morning, everyone. Morning, everyone. It's good to be in the house of the Lord today. It's good to see everyone in the house. Are you happy to be in the house of the Lord? Happy Resurrection Sunday, everyone. I'm going to ask you to do something for me. I'm going to ask you all to join hands with each other today as we pray. We're going to unite together. And I'm going to share something before I pray. I'm going to show you, because you may not be able to see it clearly. This is the news, yes? So it's not something that is hidden, and it may be hard for you to see it. But what are we celebrating today? It doesn't seem like the church is celebrating Jesus today. What are we celebrating today? Resurrection Sunday. Jesus is not dead. Jesus is alive. Amen. And what I just showed you, it says President Joe Biden has officially proclaimed March 31st as Transgender Day of Visibility. Hato kasuya masie tere kosanda darabusu yokoshende. And this, for us as a church, we should be ready to stand up and declare Jesus as what? Lord over today. Jesus is risen today. Jesus is alive today. March 31st, we are declaring Jesus Christ risen from the dead. So it's not time to be joking. Hallelujah. So today, Father God, I put before you your people. I want you to pray with me, because we are coming together. We are uniting together to declare March 31st, Resurrection Sunday, Jesus Christ alive and well. Proclamation that Jesus is Lord over heaven, Lord over earth, Lord over England, Lord over America, Lord over Africa, Lord over the Caribbean, Lord over Australia. Jesus is what? Hallelujah. So you should be mad in your spirit this morning. If your spirit is alive, you should be upbeat today to declare Jesus. Jesus as Lord, being priest of this house. Jesus Christ is priest over this house, and he has made us priests with him. So today, Father, I put before you every single individual in this house. Father God, I pray that the eyes of their understanding will be enlightened today. I pray, as Paul said, that they will know the calling in which they have been called and the riches of your glory. Father God, the call that we are called to fellowship, the call that we have been called to unite, the call that we have called to pray and to bring down every stronghold, every evil device, every snake, every serpent, every viper today in the name of Jesus. I'm not here in the church praying. It seems like you're okay for today to be a transgender visibility day and not Jesus Christ day. Reno momo siete de kosandali akoshai. Romo momo siete. Ye no momo sandai. I pray today that, Father, every dead situation, every dead spirit, everything, Father God, that is in the grave today will be resurrected. I declare that resurrection to health. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare resurrection to finances. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare resurrection and prosperity over your people, Father God. if they don't know what they, Lord God Almighty, is their inheritance, I declare that their eyes will be open to their inheritance today in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the powerful name. In the resurrection power. In the resurrection power of Jesus Christ, I declare lordship of this house to Jesus Christ over our nations, over your family, over your marriage, over your children. In the name of Jesus, they will not be swept away by evil doctrines. They will not be swept away by the system and the patterns of this world. In the mighty name of Jesus, we take full authority as kings and priests, and we decree and we declare that Jesus Christ in us, that we have seated in heavenly places in Christ, and we take full authority. We take full authority over March 31st. We take full authority over March 31st. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I declare that the water is troubled this morning. I declare that the water is troubled this morning. Father God, as Lord God Almighty, your daughter and your son, declare, Father God, they are receiving salvation. I declare, Father God, that the manifestation of your power, Lord God Almighty, that they will be baptized by the water, baptized by the Spirit, baptized by the blood today, that we will see a manifestation of the power of Jesus Christ in this house. That, Lord God Almighty, every mouth that cannot be opened, every mouth, Lord God Almighty, that the enemy has shut, every snake that has wrapped is wrapped around your people today, they will be loose. Loose them from every infirmity. Loose them from every bondage that is holding them captive. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray, Lord God Almighty, for your leader today. I pray for your bishop. I pray for his wife and his family. I pray, Lord God Almighty, that you overshadow them today. And Father, let everything that is done and everything that will be said in this house be unto your honor, be unto the glory of your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God, hallelujah. Bless the Lord, hallelujah. We're going to be, thank you very much for that, Deacon Janice. We're going to be worshiping the Lord in giving. I forgot again, sometimes I do this, to welcome those who are watching on our live stream. God bless you. Thank you for joining us this morning. And I also want to say good morning to our baptismal candidates. If you could just give everyone a wave. Just give everyone a wave and we'll be hearing from them. And I serve notice on you now. We have clothes. We have baptizers. We have water. We have time. Do you have the obedience? Do you have the obedience? That voice that's telling you, you know what, you should be getting baptized today, you know, it should be you. That voice is the Holy Spirit. If you want to obey the Lord, then I would encourage you to do so. If you want to disobey him, then again, that's your choice. But it's not a nice thing to do, and it's not a good thing to do. So I'm going to invite the worship team to come. Just to remind you that if you are a UK taxpayer, please feel free to complete a gift aid envelope, which you can get from one of our stewards. It enables us as a church to claim about 25 pence in every pound that you give. You could also, if you want to give your tithes and offering by way of card, we do have a card machine over there which allows you to pay from a debit or credit card accordingly. Also, you could use the QR code, which was previously mentioned in our announcements. Can we stand, please? Father God, I just want to thank you, thank you, thank you, that your goodness and mercy lasts forever. You are so good. You are our provider. You are our sustainer. You are our keeper. And so, Lord God, as we worship you with our finances, I pray, Father God, that as we prayed for different ways of resurrection, that there will be a resurrection in our finances today. I pray in the name of Jesus that there will be an anointing flowing from this act of worship. And I pray, Father God, there will be a blessing that will just land upon our lives and upon our families as a result of obeying you in worship and giving. Father, I thank you, Lord God, for everything that you've provided for us. We bless you. We give to you gladly. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Blessing time.
Offering time.
Offering time.
Blessing time.
Can I hear some volume? Blessing time.
Offering time.
Offering time.
Blessing time.
Amen. God is good. God is amazing. We're going to sing a nice medley, quite a Jamaican mix. So if you don't know it, the words will be on the screen. Follow through. Dance, sing, clap your hands, wave your hands. You're free in the sanctuary. Hallelujah.
What can wash away my sin? Hallelujah, redeemed.
Redeemed.
Redeemed. When my burden of sin was high, redeemed. When my soul condemned to die, redeemed. For the parts I could not bear, redeemed. Hallelujah, redeemed.
Lifted me up from the miry clay.
He planted my feet on the rock to stay.
And that
is the reason why I sing and I shout. My Savior came down and lifted me up. He lifted me up from the miry clay. My feet on the rock to stay,
and that
is the reason why I sing and I shout. My Savior came down and lifted me up.
Thank God
for the cleansing blood. Thank God for the cleansing.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Can we continue just to play that gently? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'd ask you to remain standing. Hallelujah. As our speaker for this morning comes to the podium, if you could just play that refrain. Hallelujah. Praise God. How precious is the flow, hallelujah, that makes us white as snow. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask you to stretch your hands towards this morning's speaker. Hallelujah. As we pray, hallelujah, that God will speak through his servant this morning. Hallelujah, that the words will be directly from the throne of grace. Hallelujah, that the words will bring life, hallelujah, in dead situations, that will bring hope, hallelujah, to those that have no hope. But the words, hallelujah, will enlighten, hallelujah, those that are in darkness, hallelujah. And that we will receive what God has for us. Those that do not know him, through the words of this sermon, will come into relationship with Jesus, the risen Savior. Those, hallelujah, that are standing between two opinions regarding their baptism will say, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Today is the day. I thank you for your servant. I pray that you will use him in a mighty way. Hallelujah. Chains will be broken through your word, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Preach the word. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name.
Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. Oh, precious, come on, let's lift up our hands this morning.
Oh, precious
is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. But the blood
nothing
of Jesus.
The
just
blood
one more time.
Oh,
precious.
Oh, precious
is the flow that
makes me white as snow.
No other fact.
Nothing but the blood.
Hallelujah, nothing. For your healing, nothing but the blood. And your deliverance, nothing but the blood. Your restoration, nothing but the blood. He's a way maker because nothing but the blood. Nothing but the blood. Nothing but the blood.
Nothing but the blood.
Nothing but the blood. Jesus,
nothing but
the blood of Jesus,
nothing but the blood
over your life, hallelujah,
nothing but the blood
over your family,
nothing but the blood,
nothing but the blood,
nothing but the blood,
declare it this morning, nothing but the blood,
nothing but the blood,
nothing but the blood,
nothing but the blood,
hallelujah,
nothing but the blood,
nothing but the blood, hallelujah,
nothing but the blood
of Jesus, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
praise the Lord,
hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, come on, you can celebrate. Hallelujah. It's because of the blood. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, we give you praise, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Can we give him another praise in the house? Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I want you just to stay in the attitude and the atmosphere of worship, praise and worship this morning. Hallelujah. It is Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. We have a right to give God praise. Amen. We have a right to give God praise. Hallelujah. I greet everybody in the wonderful name of Jesus. I greet those online who are watching perhaps online. And I just greet my bishop and our assistant pastor who's away preaching overseas. And I greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday, baptism. Hallelujah. It is awesome to be in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. I'm so excited to be in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Is anybody excited? Does anybody still get that excitement? Hallelujah. I start thinking about church in the week, but I start thinking, getting excited on Saturday, because you know what? You never know what God will do. You have to be open to what God can do, and we must never come here expecting the same old thing. We must never expect what we received last week. There is something new every time we come into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It is Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. The resurrection power is still available today. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm just going to speak not too long, because we have the act of baptism to take this morning. Hallelujah. But I just want to leave a brief word for you. Hallelujah. The resurrection power is still available for today, church. Amen. The resurrection is the cornerstone of our faith. Our faith relies on the fact that Jesus not only died on the cross, but he rose from the dead. Hallelujah. If that were not a reality, there would be no Christian faith. One of the first sermons preached at Pentecost was preached by Peter, and he preached on the resurrection. And throughout the epistles, we see the preaching of the resurrection. It tells us that we must speak about the resurrection, church. Amen. We must declare the resurrection. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If Christ's bones were still in Jerusalem, there would be no hope for anyone in the world. But his body is not there. Hallelujah. He is alive. Hallelujah. And has been resurrected. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus' resurrection is the Bible's greatest miracle. and history's greatest fact. Thank you, Jesus. Without the resurrection, there will be no faith. And as I said, resurrection is the cornerstone of our faith. Thank you, Jesus. Romans 10 and verse 9 talks about us being made alive in Christ. If he is still dead, we cannot be made alive, church. Amen? Romans 10 and verse 9 says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. If he had not been raised, then there would be no saving grace. Hallelujah. The resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ comes with great power. Power that we must rely on today. I'm talking about resurrection power for today. In our efforts to continue to grow, it's usually there, but our vision for this year is growth. But in efforts to grow our faith, we must continue to rely on this power. Hallelujah. Without the resurrection power, preaching would be in vain. Faith would be in vain. Sin would have dominion. Death would have dominion. And our futures would be fearful. But he's alive. Hallelujah. And he keeps his promises. And there's something wonderful, wonderful in yours and mine's future. Our future is bright. Hallelujah. The power of the resurrection can mold us. Hallelujah. It can conform us in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The resurrection, church, is more than a fairy tale. It's more than a historical event. It's more than just another story in the Bible. The resurrection has power to affect your life even today. Hallelujah. Philippians 3 and verse 10 says, this is Paul speaking, he says, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering, being made conformable unto death. Paul says, that I may know him. Oh, that we may know him, church. Oh, that we may know him and know the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah. That I may know the power of this resurrection. Thank you, Jesus. What is resurrection? Simply, the meaning of the word resurrection is raising or rising up from the dead back to life. But Paul said something unique in Philippians 3 verse 10. He says, I want to experience this resurrection power. I want to have that power working in me. Does anybody want that power? Does anybody desire that power? Paul says, I want to know the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah. That I may know. Hallelujah. His working in me. Thank you, Jesus. So how does the resurrection power affect us today? Resurrection brings new life, church. Ephesians 2 and verses 1 through to 10 talks about us being dead in our sins. But verse 5 says, through the resurrection, we have been made alive. Hallelujah. Romans 6 and verses 1 to 4 talks about in Christ, we have a new life. We are born again. Hallelujah. And 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are new. The power of resurrection gives new life. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. The power of the resurrection gives eternal life. Hallelujah. You remember when Jesus was on his way to Lazarus? Lazarus had passed away and had been in the tomb. But as he approached, Martha came up to him and said, Jesus said to her, you know what? Your brother will rise again. Hallelujah. Martha said to him, I know he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day. But Jesus had to correct her and said, you know what, my sister? I am the resurrection. The resurrection is standing in front of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he that believes in me will live. And even though they die, and whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? He says to her, I am the resurrection. You're looking at the resurrection right now. You don't have to wait until the end of time, but the resurrection is standing right in front of you. I tell you this morning, church, that the resurrection power is here. Amen? Let me say that again. The resurrection power is here. It's in this place. Hallelujah. His resurrection power is resurrecting me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I am the resurrection, Jesus says. Hallelujah. The resurrection power gives us the faith to call on the name Jesus. Somebody call on the name Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody call it again, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Call it one more time, church. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The most powerful name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's the power of the resurrection, church, that has Satan under our feet. Hallelujah. Begin to trample him under your feet, because it's the power of the resurrection that is holding him down under your feet. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The resurrection power is too strong. Hallelujah. The resurrection power, the grave could not hold Jesus because of the resurrection power. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So the resurrection power has given you and I more than just faith. It's more than an eternal life. Hallelujah. But it's given us power through the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Christ, up from the grave, he arose with a mighty triumph. We sang it already this morning, over his foes. Hallelujah. I'm talking about resurrection power for today. I'm talking about the same power that raised Jairus' daughter. Amen? His daughter had passed away. And Jesus was on his way. He healed the woman with the issue of blood. And as he was on his way to Jairus' daughter, the news came that she has passed away. So everyone was saying, don't trouble the teacher. Leave it. And Jesus entered the house and said that she is sleeping. And they mocked him. And Jesus put them out. And he took the parents and took three disciples. And she was raised back to life. Hallelujah. Sometimes you need to put people out, church. People were there mocking him, saying, what do you mean that she's alive? She's passed away. But Jesus said, out. And he pulled the people who were important in this act, the parents, come with me, and three disciples, and raised her back to life. Hallelujah. I'm talking about the same power that has authority over demons, church. I'm talking about the same power that healed the leper. Hallelujah. I'm talking about the same power that can heal you today in the mighty name of Jesus. God still heals. He still set free. He still delivers. Hallelujah. So many people are seeking God's power. And they seem to think it's a thing or a force that can be used for their own needs, perhaps, and wants. But the problem with thinking about that is that we need to understand that it's the love of Jesus. It was love that sent Jesus into the world, church. It was love that why he died on an old rugged cross. Hallelujah. It was love that exploded Jesus from the tomb. Hallelujah. I love the account. I think it's in Matthew or perhaps it's in Luke. When the ladies are going to the tomb and the stone is rolled away. Hallelujah. The resurrection power removes stones. Hallelujah. Removes blockages from your life. Hallelujah. And when they entered, the angel said, why are you looking for the living among the dead? He is not here. He is risen. Hallelujah. What are you doing here? This is where dead people stay. But he is not here. He is risen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So it was love that exploded Jesus out of the tomb. It was love that healed the blind. Hallelujah. It was love that raised the dead. Hallelujah. It was love. God so loved the world that he gave his only son, so that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. God loved us so much, he sent his son, hallelujah, to die for us. It is love that holds us together. When everything else has passed away, hallelujah, love will remain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's the same power, church. Oh, thank you, Jesus. The resurrection power is a conquering power. Amen? To conquer is to subdue. It's to win. It's to overcome by force. We know that the enemy comes to steal, doesn't he? John 10, verse 10, he says, the thief comes to steal and kill and destroy. And these are tools that the devil uses. But Jesus has conquered, hallelujah, and overcome on our behalf. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus was flogged. The enemy was trying to steal his dignity and strength. He was trying to break him. That's what the enemy does. But Jesus went the distance. Every stripe meant victory for us, church. Hallelujah. So the enemy tried to break him. Have you ever felt like you have been broken or you feel like you're about to break because of the pressure? Hallelujah. Jesus was crucified. The enemy wanted to kill him. This is what the enemy desires for us as well. But his blood, hallelujah, purchased my salvation. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Jesus was buried. He was sealed in a tomb by a stone. And the enemy wanted to destroy him for good. He wanted no more mention of Jesus. That was the enemy's desire. And so it is with us. He wants us to be buried and sealed in a tomb. Hallelujah. He doesn't want to hear our names being mentioned. He doesn't want us to preach. He doesn't want you to sing. He doesn't want you to praise. He doesn't want you to pray. He wants you buried behind a tomb. But I'm talking about resurrection power this morning. Hallelujah. That is still available. Hallelujah. It is still available today. And if you feel like you are sealed in a tomb, hallelujah, and you need help to roll the stone away. Hallelujah. Whatever that stone might be, whether it's sickness, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. I feel like some stones need to be rolled away. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Stones of sickness in particular, we shouldn't stand for them in the mighty name of Jesus. We're not standing for them anymore. Hallelujah. Somebody help me. We are not standing for the stone of sickness. Hallelujah. That is trying to bury you. Hallelujah. For good. It's trying to take you out. But there's a resurrection power. Hallelujah. That can roll away that stone. Because for some of us, the stone is too heavy. Hallelujah. The stone is too stiff. The stone won't move. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But there's a power, church. There's a resurrection power. Hallelujah. Available to us that has not lost its power. Hallelujah. That is still potent to today. Hallelujah. That resurrection power can roll away the stone. Hallelujah. Of sickness on your life. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because of the resurrection, death has been defeated. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Death and hell and the grave could not hold him. No matter how much they tried to hold on, they could not hold him. Hallelujah. Because the power was so strong. Hallelujah. The resurrection power could not be stopped. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So the resurrection power is a conquering power. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want to tell you that you are an overcomer because of the resurrection. The resurrection gives us hope, church, and it gives us a continual victory. Amen. Hallelujah. Not of ourselves, but in the power of God. Hallelujah. There is no storm. There is no valley. There is no attack. There is no need that God cannot handle. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. There's no storm. Hallelujah. There's no attack from the enemy. There's no need that is too great that God cannot handle. Let me say it again. There is no valley. There is no storm. There is no attack. Hallelujah. There is no need that God cannot handle. Hallelujah. Some of you ought to be thinking about your need that you need right now. The situation that you find yourself in. I want to remind you, because of the resurrection power. Hallelujah. That God can handle it. Oh, thank you, Jesus. There is no storm. There is no valley. Some of us have been in valleys. Hallelujah. Some of us have been in deep valleys. And you might even find yourself in a valley right now. Some of us are under attack. Some of us are in need. But because of God and his resurrection, God can handle it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We are overcomers. Hallelujah. It doesn't mean that trouble will disappear. It doesn't mean that you won't face persecution or difficulty. But we need to look at it from another perspective and wisdom, that we can go to a God who's not dead. He's still alive. Hallelujah. And his power is available. Hallelujah. You don't have to wait for resurrection power. Hallelujah, because it's available today. Hallelujah, and it will continue to be available. It's not just for today, church. Hallelujah, because Jesus got up. You can get up today. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how far you have come, how difficult your life has become. Hallelujah, that's insignificant because of Jesus, because he got up. So can you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jeremiah 32 and verse 27, it says, behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for me? There's nothing too hard for God, church. Hallelujah. Nothing too hard for you. You have a bright future. Hallelujah. He holds your future in his hands. Hallelujah. God exists out of time. And he sees, and he's the beginning, and he's the end. Hallelujah. He's not surprised by the world events. He's not caught off guard. Hallelujah. But he holds your future. Some of us are concerned about our future. We're concerned even about Monday morning. We're concerned about next week. Hallelujah. But because of the resurrection power, we can declare he holds the future. Hallelujah. And I know my life is worth the living just because he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know, because I know, because I know, because I know, he holds the future. Hallelujah. And well, life is worth the living just because he lives. Because he lives, because he lives. I can face, you can face, church, tomorrow. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You have a bright future. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He holds the future. Hallelujah. 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 And life is worth. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 And life is worth you, Jesus. I said it's worth, church. It's worth, hallelujah. It's worth, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 'Cause life is worth. Hallelujah, because he lives. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Resurrection power, hallelujah, seems impossible. But I want you just to understand that you might have an impossible situation, but the resurrection seemed impossible. Hallelujah. And I want you to expect God to come through for you for the impossible, church. Hallelujah. Resurrection joy. Some of us need to experience resurrection joy again. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's as if Christ hasn't died for you. It's as if he didn't hung upon a tree for you. It's as if, hallelujah, he didn't go to the cross for you. Experience his resurrection joy. Use the resurrection authority. Hallelujah. 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 Use the resurrection authority. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Experience his resurrection, the confidence that we have in him. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, praise the Lord. Praise Him. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord, church. His resurrection power is available. His resurrection power is available. Hallelujah. And if you need His resurrection power, you need to call out to Him. Just stand on your feet at this time. Come on, just stand on your feet. Thank you, Jesus. His resurrection power is available. It's calling you. Hallelujah. And if you are not a born-again Christian, that maybe at this time you would want to give your life to Christ. Hallelujah. Or maybe you just say, you know what? I haven't been walking in the resurrection power. It's available, church. Hallelujah. And I want to encourage you, you know what? Your future is bright. Your future is secure. Hallelujah. It's secure because He lives. And you know what? You can face tomorrow. When tomorrow comes, say good morning. Because the resurrected King is going to resurrect you for that day, for that week. Hallelujah. Because He lives. Because He lives. Because He lives. Hallelujah, lives. Hallelujah, I can face tomorrow. Hallelujah.
Because He lives.
Thank you, Jesus. All fear.
All fear is gone.
Because He lives,
I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives.
Because He lives.
Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone.
Because I know.
Because
because he lives, because I know, because I know. Because he lives, can we just lift our voices another time in adoration?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Because he lives, we can face today, we can face tomorrow. He never left us, nor did he forsake us. He lives. He lives. He lives. He lives.
He lives. Hallelujah.
And he is on the throne.
Amen.
He is on the throne.
Hallelujah.
He lives. Hallelujah. Our God saves. Our God heals.
Amen.
Our God delivers.
Amen.
Our God sets free.
Hallelujah.
He lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God saves. Our God saves.
There is hope.
There is hope.
In your name.
In your name. Morning turns. Morning turns to songs of praise, to songs of praise. Our God saves, 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 our God saves,
our God saves.
Our God saves. There is hope. There is hope. In your name.
In your name.
Morning turns. Morning turns. To songs of praise. To songs of praise. Our God saves. Our God saves. Our God saves, our God saves, our God saves, our God saves, yes he does, our God saves. To songs of praise, our God saves.
Our God saves.
Our God saves. Our God saves. Our God saves. Our God saves. Yes, he does. Our God saves. To songs of praise, our God saves, our God saves, our God saves. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
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 Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord. Let's hear that again. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
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 Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
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 Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise
ye the Lord. Praise ye. Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord. Praise
ye the Lord. Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship with one accord.
Every praise,
every praise, every praise,
every praise.
It's to who?
It's to our God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Every praise is to our God.
Every word of worship with one accord.
One accord.
Every praise,
every praise,
every praise.
Is to our God.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah. To our God.
Glory hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Is to our God.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise. Is to our God.
Every praise. Every praise.
Every praise. Is to our God. Every word of worship with one accord. Every praise is to our God.
God my Savior.
God my Savior.
God my healer.
Every word of worship with one accord.
Every praise,
every praise,
every praise,
every praise
is to our God. Sing hallelujah,
sing hallelujah
to our glory. Hallelujah,
hallelujah
is to our
God.
Every praise,
every praise.
Every praise,
every praise,
every praise,
every praise,
every praise,
every praise,
hallelujah, every praise,
every praise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Has anyone got a praise in the house this morning for the Lord? Hallelujah. Every praise is to our God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We lift up his holy name. We've now come to the baptismal part of what has been a wonderful Easter Sunday. And I'm going to call upon Reverend Wayne to just come and pray. Just to remember what I said earlier, we have water, we have clothes, we have baptizers, we just need your obedience. Just need your obedience. Reverend Wayne.
Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, we give you thanks, Lord, for this moment, Lord, this time, oh Father, Lord, as we are about to carry the act of baptism, oh Father, Lord. We just pray for your baptismal candidates at this time, Lord. Bless them, Lord. Touch them, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We pray, Lord, for resurrection power over their lives, over their families, oh Father, Lord. We pray, oh Father, even those, Lord, who may not have made a decision, Lord, and are still pondering, hallelujah, at this time, Lord. Hallelujah. We pray, oh God, that you will convict them, oh God, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we pray, Lord, that the water, Lord, will be troubled this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your power, hallelujah, and your presence, oh God, hallelujah, be in this place, Lord, hallelujah, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we give you thanks, we give you praise, in Jesus' name, amen.
Sorry. First of all, greetings everyone. Happy Easter to you all. Thank you everyone for being here. I've decided to be baptized today because God is my savior. He's been good to me. I have many testimonies in my life. If I start one, I'll probably be here all day, and I know everyone wants to get home. So I'll start off with the most recent one. I was recently in hospital. God brought me out. I'm here today. So amen and thank you.
This is Leah Massey. I've known Leah for many years, and I'm so glad that she has decided to take this step of faith and step of obedience and go through the waters of baptism. And Leah, the journey's just starting for you. There is greatness within you,
and just allow yourself to be used by the Lord. God has invested so much in you, and just allow him to pour through you as you continue to be a blessing to others. And so, Leah, upon the background of your testimony and the profession of your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, I now baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yes, I thank you, oh Lord. Yes, I thank you, oh Lord. Looking back in my life, I see all the things you have done for me. I thank you, oh Lord. Yes, I thank you, oh Lord. Yes, I thank you, oh Lord. Looking back in my life, I see all the things you have done for me. I thank you, oh Lord. Yes, I thank you, oh Lord. Yes, I thank you, oh Lord. Looking back in my life, I see all the things you have done for me. I thank you, oh Lord.
Yes, I thank you. Yes, I thank you, oh Lord. Yes, I thank you. Me, I thank you, oh Lord.
Good morning, church. Happy Easter, everyone. I'd just like to proclaim God as my Savior. I thank God for everything that he's done for me. There was some times where things looked impossible, but God made everything possible, and I just want to walk in God going forward, because he has worked miracles in my life.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Praise
Amen.
Lord.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Here we have Nina. Amen. Ready to. She's given her testimony. We've heard that God has done the impossible for her, and he will continue to do what seems to be impossible in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. So at this time, Nina, take great pleasure, because of the background of your testimony and the profession of your faith, we take great pleasure in baptizing you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All my life you have been faithful.
All my life, hallelujah.
All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
First of all, let me say a good day to one and all.
Amen.
And please allow me to quote from Psalm 118, verse 15. There are glad songs of victory in the tent of the righteous today. And it's because of that victory that we are here today.
Yes.
Amen.
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 This is my second time of calling. I had the last ceremony. I actually put my name down, but didn't follow through. There's a reason for that. And it's simply because I had some doubts. Thomas had his doubts, Peter had his doubts, and many doubts Peter had. So allow me to have doubts. I was not struggling with my faith, because that has been solid from the time of an infant. My mother taking me to church three times on Sundays. Midday 11 o'clock service, 3 o'clock Sunday school, and back for 7 at night. What I was struggling with was not my faith. I had no doubts about my faith. What I was struggling with, was it necessary for me to go through a third passage or rite of passage? Having been baptized in the Anglican Church, having been confirmed in the Anglican Church, why is it I haven't or wasn't seen to be saved? I talked to many people about it. Are the people who sit in the congregation every Sunday in those churches not saved? Many people gave different explanations. But to satisfy myself, I went to that one place that is an authority, the Bible. And first of all, I went to the teachings of Paul. He, the great salvationist, evangelist of the New Testament, the pillar of the New Testament. And at Romans 10:9, this is what Paul said about being saved. That if we confess with our lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in our hearts that God raised him from the dead, we are saved. So there you are. Paul is talking about confession and belief. There was nothing in that passage about baptism. There was nothing in that passage about going through the third rite of passage. So I said, something is not right here. I said, let me look further. And I went to Peter at Acts 2 in his sermon of rebuke and the need for repentance to the Israelites for having been involved in the crucifixion of Jesus. He declared to those wayward Israelites that God has made Jesus Lord and Christ, the one they crucified. He implored them to repent for such an act and be baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of their sins and the receiving of the Holy Spirit. So here we are, baptism now being mentioned. Following that sermon, 3,000 people were baptized. What about the approach of Jesus, the authority, our Savior, our leader, the Messiah, the teacher? At John 3:5, responding to the doubts of Nicodemus, the then ruler of the Jews, as to how a man can enter his mother's womb and be born again, Jesus, in reply, said, except a person is born of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. So there we had the authority. Yes. We then asked the question, what is this water? But water is in the Church of England. The water of spiritual rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit. Being saved by the grace of God through faith in Jesus Christ, that he is our Savior. He then set the example for us. He became baptized in the water. As a matter of fact, it was the River Jordan, and he was baptized by John. If he has done it, why can't I do it? Of course I will. I'm ready.
This is Victor. I nearly was tempted to say Minister Victor. But we've been encouraged by your exposition of the word. And I hope that people have been touched and encouraged as a result. You know, you've been with us for maybe a year, year and a half, maybe 2 years now. And very rarely do I see someone with a heart for the people in the community and a heart for people that I see in you. And I'm glad that the Lord has brought you to us at such a time like this. And may he use you to his glory, continue to use you to his glory. So Victor, upon the background of your testimony, the profession of your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, I now baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen. I am blessed. I am blessed. Every day of my life, I am blessed. When I wake up in the morning, I am blessed every day of my life.
in the morning and I lay my head to rest. I am blessed. I am blessed.
Hallelujah. 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 We want to celebrate what God has done in the lives of those baptismal candidates this morning. But as I, or this afternoon rather, but as I said earlier, we have water, we have baptizers, all we just need is your obedience. You know, and I'm going back some time here. When I was younger, much younger, this is something that normally girls would do. There were these flowers, and I'm not sure if they were called forget-me-nots, but they used to pick them. And when they kind of were attracted to another guy, it was so straightforward back in those days. When they were attracted to another guy, they would pick each petal of the flower, and they would say, he loves me, he loves me not, he loves me, he loves me not. And if you get to the last petal on that flower, and it's he loves me, oh, there's this, you know, it proves he loves me. Or if you get to the last petal on the flower and it's he loves me not, then it means that you just get another flower.
Yeah.
And do it till it works. And sometimes we, there's some of us here who have that kind of relationship with God. We question whether or not he loves me or he loves me not. He loves me, he loves me not. My question is, what more does God need to do to prove to you that he loves you? Yes, you may have messed up. Yes, you may have fallen away. Yes, you may have done the wrong things at times, but he loves you. And if anything this weekend tells us, when Jesus died on Good Friday, when he said it's finished, when he spread out his arms and died for your sins and my sins, that was proof that he loves you. And so you need to respond. You need to respond. We're going to stand at this time. If everyone could stand. And if you could just bow your heads, please. And if there's anyone here who knows that today is the day that they should be going through these waters of baptism, I want to encourage you to say that, yes, we have water. Yes, we have baptizers. We just need your obedience. If that is you, whilst every head is bowed, I want you to just raise your hand. If you want to be baptized this morning, we have time. If you want to be baptized this morning, or if you want to give your life to the Lord Jesus this morning, today is your day. Today is your day. Do you know, if there's one thing that this season has taught me, is that you cannot take life for granted. You cannot take life for granted. People who you expect to be there the next day, or the next month, they're no longer here. Don't leave this earth alone. Leave with Christ Jesus. If it's your time to pass, make sure you leave with Christ Jesus in your life. And you can make that decision right now. You don't have to wait for any classes. You don't have to wait for any more songs. You just need to make that decision now. So with every head bowed, every eye closed, if you're here and you'd like to be baptized this morning, or you want to give your life to the Lord, just raise your hand high. We'll make time for you. Just lift your hands high. Don't let this moment pass by. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you for the work of the cross. I want to thank you for the power of the resurrection. I want to thank you that new life is offered and new life is available. Father, we know how some people may struggle making that decision. But we pray against those hindrances. We pray against those blockages. We pray against those chains in the name of Jesus. And we proclaim liberty into their situation and into their lives. Father, we pray that this day will not end without them making a commitment to you. We pray that they will not be ashamed to say yes to you, Lord Jesus. And in doing so, we know that they will receive you as you welcome them. And so, Lord, as we as baptizers are about to leave this pool, I pray a blessing upon this congregation. I pray, Father God, that this day will not end without someone yielding to you, without someone confessing their sins and recognizing that they need you. There's so many things that we are striving for in life and not realizing that the most thing, the best thing that we need is you. Father, in the name of Jesus, open our eyes. Lift the scales from our eyes so that we see you and only you. Lord, we bless you and we thank you. We thank you for the candidates who've gone through these waters in obedience. Thank you for the change. Thank you for their obedience. Thank you for doing great things in their life. We lift you up and praise you in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. God bless you. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Bless God. I hope you were blessed by the service. But the service doesn't end in here. We're going to be going round the back shortly for fellowship. There is some food that's been provided by the church and Leah's family. And I would invite you to stay and just enjoy the refreshments. I'm going to ask you to take your seats for a second, for a moment. And I'm going to ask any child aged 11 or under to stand. If you are age 11 or under, can you stand? Bless God. Okay, I want you to come forward. We have a sweet treat for you to enjoy. So come forward. Do we have any young person age 16 to 12? 16 to 12. It's your turn. Age 16 to 12. few more moments to worship here before we go and fellowship at the back. Can I also just remind you that the youth department are raising funds, so they're selling some fried fish and clothes. But even if you don't have the money today, I'm sure that you can, there is a card machine as well, so you can pay for it that way. And as I said earlier, please spend some time just fellowshipping. There's some free refreshments that we really would like you to participate in. I'm going to invite you to stand.
Forever and ever, our God, you are good. Forever and ever, our God, you are good. Forever and ever, our God, you are good. Forever and ever, our God, you are good.
Praise God. We're going to pronounce our benediction. Hallelujah. And if we can have it on the overhead. And now may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Please join us at the back. Thank you.